Casino Resort in San Ynez, California. Time now for our main event. Undefeated knockout maven Latif Coyote and former amateur standout Matt Godfrey in a cruiserweight class scheduled for 10 rounds. One of the few guys without a hat in the ring, our ring announcer Mark Lichtenfeld takes it from here.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again to the Chumash Casino Resort here in beautiful Santa Ynez, California, where tonight's action is being brought to you by Gary Shaw Productions and Showtime, and seen live in Canada on Super Channel. This bout is sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission Executive Director, George Dodd, the NABF Supervisor of Ringside, Rudy Tejez, the NABA Supervisor of Ringside, Matt Paulus. Your judges for this bout once again, Kermit Bayless, Sergio Caiz, and Marshall Walker. Your referee in charge of the action is Dan Stell. And now, Santa Ynez, it's time for some chin-checking at the Chumash. This is your Showbox main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing for the NABF and vacant NABA Cruiserweight Championships. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black with white. He weighed in at an even 200 pounds. His record, 20 wins, 2 losses, 10 wins, coming by way of knockout from Providence, Rhode Island, a recent world title challenger. Please welcome Matt Too Smooth Godfrey. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white with green. He weighed in at 199.5 pounds. He is undefeated with a record of 16 wins, no losses, 14 wins, coming by way of knockout from Lagos, Nigeria. Now fighting out of Hollywood, California, the defending NABF Cruiserweight Champion, he is Latif Power Coyote. Referee Dan Stell to give the instructions.
Let's go, gentlemen. The hip line's gonna be a low blow. It's for the NABF, NABA title. Just obey my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves, come out the belt. Good luck to both of you.
Kurt, I think we should make Tarver wear one of those hats next time he works with us.
I wonder, is it St. Patrick's Day? He's got green gloves, too.
Mouthpiece, sir.
Coyote with a major reach advantage. Godfrey told us his mission number one tonight, take away Latif's jab. It'll be interesting to see if he can do that without getting inside. Rules, same as the second fight, no standing in, no 3 knockdown. Only ref can stop the fight. Can't be saved by the bell in any round. And we got to go 4 rounds if the fight is stopped because of an accidental foul before we go to the cards.
Scheduled for 10 rounds. This cruiserweight matchup, Latif Coyote and Matt Godfrey. And Godfrey told us he planned to come out in a left-handed stance just to see what Coyote would do, but also he feels he sees a little bit better from that left-handed stance. What he didn't know is that Coyote beforehand had told us, hey, I hope he comes out in a left-handed stance because that works to my advantage.
Yeah, well, Godfrey fights southpaw quite a bit. And Coyote only fought one southpaw, but he did have a lot of southpaw sparring.
Let's go.
For this fight.
We'll see which guy was right.
Keep touching him.
Coyote with 76 amateur bouts. He was an African champion. And Godfrey, national champion in America at 201 pounds in 2000 and 2003. And pro experience, you see Godfrey only 6 more bouts, even though he turned pro 4 years before Coyote did.
Coyote is really a guy who's active during his brief pro career.
Step back.
Interesting so far, Godfrey right in the pocket. Not showing the movement that we may have expected. Latif seems happy with that.
No, stop, step back.
Well, we talked about Coyote's last bout. It was a win over Nick Iannuzzi, but he had to go the distance and win it in a decision. A lot of people thought that maybe he didn't win that. It was a little bit of a different experience for him, a guy who had knocked out 14 consecutive opponents coming in. So he feels that tonight he's actually got something to prove, even though he's the heavily favored fighter.
Well, Antonio Tarver was with us that night. He scored for Iannuzzi, but whether you did score for Coyote or not, it was not a good performance.
No, stop.
His footwork was bad. He chased.
Let's go.
And you know what? We consider Godfrey a mover because that's the way he's fought right now. Well, now he's moving a little bit laterally, but.
A couple of combinations. Godfrey just trying to wrap up, takes a shot to the chest.
No, stop, stop. He's back. You have him with that shot. Come back with that shot.
Godfrey's corner thinking that they hurt Coyote. I thought it was the other way around.
Very important here for Coyote to go to the body when he gets close enough, because Godfrey is very elusive and has already shown the ability to slip Coyote's best weapon, the biggest weapon anyway, that right hand.
Godfrey not afraid to go toe-to-toe with Coyote.
Well, I'll tell you, after chasing Iannuzzi for 10 rounds, I think Coyote's very happy that he doesn't have to chase Godfrey.
Which is what you kind of thought maybe Godfrey would come in. Oh, he gets caught by an overhand right by Coyote. Godfrey paying the price for not moving around in that first round.
It's been an issue. He's been down several times in his career.
Look, the jab and the feints are there. Okay? You got to shoot the left hand behind it, all right? Take a deep breath, okay? That's not a bad round, okay? Feints got him jumping. When he's jumping, shoot the left hand and the hook behind it, because it's all day with that. The hook's there for you. But you got to touch him with the left hand first and come behind it, okay? Get a drink. You got ice on?
This is the first time that Ross Enamite, who's really a strength and conditioning coach, has worked a corner, been the chief second of a corner.
You're in range. You got the range nice with the jab, but you got to push them behind.
It's a little bit of a mismatch of corners when Freddie Roach is in the other corner. Here's the knockdown, and that's just a lead straight right hand, seemed to catch Godfrey off guard. Really, the significance of that punch is not that necessarily scored a knockdown, but that becomes instantly a 10-8 round for Coyote.
And you heard Enamite saying, you know what, it wasn't a bad round. He was right. Until the last 10 seconds, it wasn't a bad round, but it turned rather quickly. The knockdown making it a 10-8 victory in that opening round for Latif Coyote.
Godfrey often finds himself behind the eight ball because of that shaking chin. Down three times Marco Hawk, down against Sims, down against Nuoto. I think he was down in his pro debut. It's a common theme for him.
Not exactly the way you want to come into a fight against a guy nicknamed Power.
Exactly.
Coyote came into this one looking to score a knockout. Not only because he feels that Godfrey is vulnerable, but as I said, because he didn't perform well in his last outing, he wants to restart a knockout streak, although he admits that not getting a knockout took some of the pressure off him.
No, no, stop. Stop that.
Godfrey can be elusive, but you know what? If he's back to the ropes or the corners, not a good thing for him. Now Coyote seemingly willingly goes back to the ropes.
Maybe trying to draw Godfrey in.
No, no, stop. Don't wrestle, gentlemen. Let's go.
Tied up.
Let's fight.
Cantel breaking him up. Coyote missed both those shots. It catches him in the chest. Backs Godfrey up against the ropes. Then a shot to the chin with a right hand. Godfrey needs to get off those ropes.
Stop.
Well, Latif has heavy hands. We know that. And Godfrey's now felt those heavy hands. He is moving more than he did in the first round. And Godfrey letting that left hand go. Even though he has some good early round knockouts, I don't consider Matt Godfrey a puncher. Good counterpuncher, though.
And he comes into this fight admitting he's at a crossroads in his career. After losing his last bout, which was four title, and dropping his record to 20-2, he knows that if he loses again, it may be hard to get back on the right track.
And the winner is in great shape for this fight because there's so few, there's such a dearth of American cruiserweights or American-based cruiserweights.
Bring him up.
Godfrey moving a lot more here in the second round than he did in the opening.
No, no, stop.
Two clinch again.
Well, Godfrey can be elusive, as I said, when he's along the ropes, but it's not a good place for him to be.
No, no, stop.
Stowe breaks him up again. Inside 20 seconds.
When you're first,
Godfrey trying to draw in Coyote. Doesn't work. And we reach the end of round two.
Don't turn it.
Deep breath. Don't go to him with the little behind the jab and the feint. Okay? Alright? The lead right hand is a little bit too long. You go the right hand to the body for now. Break him down to the body with that right hand, okay? Let's work behind the jab a little bit more for me, okay? Alright?
An interesting relationship between Latif Coyote and the legendary Freddie Roach. And Coyote told us he felt he disappointed Roach in his last performance. And that was weighing on him as much as anything.
Yeah, exactly. He was clearly emotional about it.
Ready to start round three.
Interesting that Matt Godfrey a few years ago actually worked out at the Wild Card Gym. And I don't think Freddie trained him necessarily, but clearly saw him and got a feel for him.
He said he got some pointers from Freddie, because Freddie's such a nice guy.
Right.
He just advised a young boxer.
No, stop, Godfrey admitted
he probably doesn't remember me. He just gave me a few pointers, but it was something that he certainly remembers.
Let's see if Coyote listens to Freddie Roach, who said start aiming that right hand at the body a little bit. I think he felt he was depending on it too much after scoring that knockdown at the end of the first round with that right hand.
Godfrey tries to step into a punch, but Coyote able to turn him around. Godfrey holding on. Smart.
It's early in the fight, but Godfrey needs some kind of offense that's meaningful. You know, that jab is, he's sticking that jab out. He's not really landing with any snap.
Tries to step into that one, yeah.
That's what he needs to do. That got me.
Oh, he's hit and stumbled with a shot to the body.
Hard to tell if he was off balance or hurt from the shot.
Now he turns his back to Coyote. Tries the jab. It's almost a slap jab the way he's going.
It's okay to jab that way if you're just introducing something big, a power shot, but he's not following with that shot.
Gets caught with a power shot from Coyote, rocks his head back, and now Coyote punching him on the ear.
And why not? One hand free.
Couple shots to the body. Bell finally comes in to break it up.
A lot of referees will call for a break in that situation, and you should. If one hand is free, you let them fight.
Once again, one hand free, more shots to the ear.
Let's go.
Godfrey's corner trying to get him to throw more than one punch at a time.
Stop! Step back.
Godfrey, on the occasion that he puts a little zip in that jab, is effective with it.
Once again, Coyote pounds the ear of Godfrey.
Stop!
That's been his most effective punch so far in this third round. Another round that goes the way of Coyote.
Action from round three. Watch their feet. Don't watch their fists. Look at Latif Coyote stepping on Godfrey. I said, was he hurt by that body shot? The replay clearly shows that the reason Godfrey stumbled was because Latif's left foot was on Godfrey's right foot. And that's a very common thing when a lefty fights a righty, the lead feet lock.
He's loading up. He's just waiting for you. You're walking right into his right hand. Because if you're not countered, I can't have you going that way. Okay. You're giving him too many chances with the right hand. You're walking right into it. Try to work around. Cut. Tip it off that front foot. Busy with the jab. Work around. Get that close. Turn around. Okay? Hit him with the right hand. Okay? Busy with it.
All right, let's go. Got to be seen. Let's bounce.
Shot.
Back up. Four, mouthpiece.
How do you have it? Four through three.
30-26, because of the first round was a 10-8 for Coyote, but I've given him all three rounds.
I'm with you here as we start round number four.
No, stop, stop.
The two clench. Coyote once again punches to the side of the head. Godfrey caught with an uppercut. You see Coyote now measuring it. Trying to deliver the big blow with a right hand.
Hold him down, let's go.
Stell stops in to break him up again.
Yeah, that right hand by Coyote might have been on the break, or after the break.
Get off that hand.
Coyote wrapping up, protecting himself. See if he goes back to just using that left hand as a measuring stick.
When Godfrey keeps his gloves real high in that peekaboo style, that's when Lateef should jab and follow with a right hand to the stomach.
A couple of effective shots as he had Godfrey against the ropes again.
Now these are big shots, and Godfrey's feeling these shots.
And he's trying to shy away from them as well.
Stop! Step back.
Yeah, watch those rabbit punches.
Let's go.
Both guys guilty. A little flesh around Godfrey's midsection, but you know what? He's never been a body beautiful type. That's just the way he's built.
He's taking a couple of shots at those body beautiful or not.
A couple of those hooks were a little low.
Well, that one, particularly with the left hand, was as well.
Yeah. And the ref's on the wrong side to see it.
Yeah.
Hands are free. Stop. Step back. Watch that shot.
Less than a minute to go here in the fourth round. Well, that cup looked effective.
Oh, I thought Coyote was hurt, but he's coming right back.
He did seem to be staggered a little bit by the shot from Godfrey, but now he comes back and answers.
No, stop, step back, step back, step
Maybe
back.
Godfrey will get a little braver now because he clearly affected Coyote with that left hand.
Off that
head. Now Coyote holding the left arm of Godfrey while punching
him. Up. Stop, step back, step back.
Wow, that's a hard round to score, Kurt.
It really is.
I mean, Coyote dominated the round, but the biggest shot in the round clearly was landed by Godfrey.
Keep it clean.
Deep breath.
Action from round four. The problem with a peekaboo defense sometimes, it's not so easy to see the shots coming, and you're content to try to block the shots. The other guy can punch right through your gloves. There's the left hand. There was a chopping shot by Godfrey, and Coyote looked hurt. Then he took a second left hand. Yeah, right to the side of the high right glove of Coyote. And you know what? We've never really had reason to question Coyote's chin. That might be the most hurt we've seen him.
Come on, very good.
Five, good, stay there. Let's go, box.
Round five of this scheduled 10-round bout. Lateef Coyote.
Stop!
And Matt Godfrey going at it.
Bring them punches up. Let's go, step out, let's go.
We might have a discrepancy here.
Good. Good.
I gave the last round to Coyote.
And I gave it to, I did too.
Okay. So 40-35, we each have it on the scorecards in favor of Coyote.
Yeah. I couldn't give Godfrey that based on one, two left hands. Not enough work. But it gives him some hope.
And that's what he needs right now. A few rounds wouldn't hurt either. Coyote seems to be content with just trying to measure him up for the big shot right now.
Stop! Step back, step back. Both of you guys are doing it. Let's go. Don't turn
the referee has to get better control of this because the rabbit punching is getting real bad.
Stop! Step back. Step back. Box.
he needs to be set.
Wow, Godfrey's corner explodes there. They thought they had Coyote hurt.
But neither guy really connecting, at least in that series. A couple of punches thrown, but not much touching. Or at least not effectively. And now Coyote has Godfrey up against the ropes.
Stop, step back, here we go.
And Stowe forced to break them up again.
Godfrey doing a good job of boxing in a small circle, making Coyote stop and set and reset.
Step back. Let's go, box.
Well, one big difference anybody could see watching these two guys is that while Godfrey's been effective with some shots,
he gets caught with a big right hand and has trouble keeping his feet.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Come here. Get up. Let's go.
Takes the mandatory eight count. Second time he's been knocked down tonight. And he doesn't look stable right now, I'll tell you that.
He was clearly hurt there, although when he went down, it was as much the result of Coyote pushing him as it was a punch.
Let go of that head.
But he looks to be in trouble with 45 seconds remaining.
Coyote's gotten away with quite a few low blows in this fight.
And he can't find a way to finish him off, at least not yet. Working the body now. Coyote trying to get Godfrey to bring his hands down. Godfrey holding on against the ropes.
Only one guy's landing shots here.
Mostly to the body. And Coyote seems to be out of energy.
But Coyote's got his left foot in front of his right. More low blows.
Oh, and then a couple of shots to the head. Godfrey not defending himself, but he finds a way to make it to the end of round five.
Godfrey squared up there, and you know what? That's a good way to let the referee get in and stop the fight. Even if you're slipping those shots, it looks like they're landing.
Matt, don't make me do something I don't want to do, man.
Fuck no.
You got to work to your right. You're giving him the right hand. You're walking right into it. You're not countering when you go to your left with the left.
Here's the knockdown, a right hand high on the head. Looks like it was to the temple. And then it becomes a rugby scrum, and Coyote eventually pushes his man down. If Coyote wasn't standing there right there, Godfrey would have gone down on his own. But I don't have a problem with a knockdown there because clearly the punch did the damage. Coyote's looking to just get off there. It is as much a throwdown as it is a knockdown. And here's the end of the round. Some low blows, big shots, but Coyote does punch heavy. And even though Godfrey's slipping those shots, he's not fighting back. He's squared up taking shots, not good.
Five rounds in the books of this scheduled 10-round bout. Latif Coyote already scored two knockdowns of Matt Godfrey, including one in the last round, but he wasn't able to finish him off despite having a lot of time left. But he seems to be a little bit more energized, does Coyote, as we start round six.
Well, judging by the first 30 seconds of this round, Kurt, it looks like Godfrey understands that he has to change gears here. He's letting that left hand go a lot more. He looks like he doesn't want to back up.
And throws in combination, something we hadn't seen a lot from him thus far.
Question is, can he out-busy Coyote without getting caught?
Coyote told us he's more prepared for this fight than any fight he's ever had. Watched a lot of tape, knew he's fighting a big man, so he sparred with Chris Areola. He comes in a lot more prepared, he felt, and with a better game plan.
So far, all that's true. And there's a lot of pressure on Coyote, not only because he looked bad last time, but because he's only a fight or two away from a world title shot, perhaps. And this is the best opponent he's ever faced.
Most experienced and most talented.
Yeah, he could get a title shot at any point because he is ranked by all four alphabet organizations.
Ranked in the top 10.
Yeah.
By all four and ranked in the top five by three of them.
But again, it's a European-dominated division. You want a title shot, you're probably going to have to get your passport.
That's called a slip, clearly. Their legs got tangled up and Coyote just kind of threw Godfrey down.
Time. Keep it clean, you understand me? I don't want no roles played. Let's go. Time in.
He's breathing heavy. Work, work.
But a busy night for Dan Stell here. Between warning him about the rabbit punches and the push downs, breaking up all the clinches.
Godfrey's jab no longer even a factor. He's been reduced to looking for that left hand.
And he may want to get out of that corner.
Stop! Fox.
Coyote gets busy every time that he's able to get Godfrey on the ropes.
Coyote's missing a lot of punches, partly because he winds up, and partly because Godfrey's good defensively. But I like the way he's coming in, because he is moving his head when he comes in. Coyote's stepping on the foot again.
You can see him doing it once again.
Stop that. Stop that. Let's go. Keep it clean. Stop.
I know that happens a lot with the lefty-righty thing, but at times it almost looks intentional.
It can be, sure. Primo Carnera supposedly did it all the time. He had size 43 shoes.
Well, don't forget that tomorrow night, yes, Showbox is back at you again, live from New York City. Tonight from California, tomorrow from New York, as we've got a couple of young, upcoming Puerto Rican prospects fighting the night before the Puerto Rican Day Parade. That's a big night for boxing annually in New York City. And this year, Showbox will be there to cover it.
All right.
Don't forget, tomorrow night, 10:35 Eastern Time, 7:35 Pacific.
Right here in the body, okay? All right, come back and look. Three punch combination, very simple.
It's not working, man. Seconds out. Seven. Mouthpiece.
Three punch combination.
Mouthpiece, seven. Let's go back up.
We have reached round seven. Latif Coyote, who's been a knockout artist, having knocked out 14 of the 16 men he's fought, has kind of slowed down the pace. Two of his last four fights have gone either 9 or 10 rounds, and here we are into the seventh. But once again, as you step up in competition, it gets harder to get those early round knockouts.
Although this is an opponent, Godfrey, who's been hurt. And in terms of going the distance, Coyote, as Kurt just mentioned, 2 times long. Godfrey much more experienced. I think Godfrey's been pretty successful going long, but not in the KO department. And as we go further here, that KO is what Godfrey needs.
Watch that back of the hand.
And that KO is what Coyote and his camp want. As they put it to us, there's a time where you go from being a prospect to a legitimate contender, and they expect tonight to be the night. Based on the competition he's facing, the Coyote's able to turn into a contender, and with shots like that, there's no reason not to believe it. Godfrey in trouble, up against the ropes. Coyote trying to finish him off. Body blows, then to the head.
Hammer-like shots by Coyote.
But unable to put Godfrey away.
That time Latif was smart. He aimed to the body much more than the head.
One thing you've seen from Coyote in the past, even with a lot of his knockouts, many of them come from an accumulation of punches, particularly to the body. And it seems as though he's kind of taken that strategy as we get into the latter rounds here.
Yeah, he's not really a one-punch guy at all. It's amazing how much more effective and how much stronger Coyote looks when he's presented with a stationary target, isn't it? You move against him and he definitely has some problems.
Right now, Godfrey just leaning on him. Coyote may have punched himself out a little bit earlier this round.
Stop, here you go.
Well, if you root for Matt Godfrey here, you think back to that one round where he landed that left hand. Stunned Coyote. First time we've ever seen Coyote stunned.
He's able to avoid those punches.
Bring that hand back. Bring that hand back.
inside 10 seconds. Both guys, I think, need a break right now.
Yep, and when Godfrey makes Coyote miss, the problem is he's not taking advantage.
Yeah. Another round in favor of Coyote.
Action from round 7. This is an extended period. Now look where the punches are aimed at. Coyote's wide open to be countered, but Godfrey's a little busy defending himself. And again, back downstairs. The only punches that landed, even if they partially landed, were the ones to the body. You see how slippery Godfrey can be. And then he wanted to turn the tide, Godfrey, and start punching himself, but he didn't do too much effective work.
There. Huh? Body, head. Okay? Left hook body, left hook head. You hear me? Go dig, dig. It's right there for you, okay? All right? You measure him with the first one, the second one will follow you, find his chin, okay? All right?
Let's go, let's
go. As we start the 8th round, Matt Godfrey clearly needing a knockout. According to my scorecard, every round in favor of Latif Coyote. And remember, he scored the knockdown at the end of the 1st round and in the 5th round as well.
He's been busier. And he certainly punches with more authority when he does punch, even though he's missed a lot of shots.
Well, he has been in control really since the end of that 1st round, because that knockdown came with about 10 seconds to go. And since a little head clash here between the two.
Stand up. No knockdown, heads collided. Let's go, rinse this.
Good call, Kurt.
Rinse this.
That's what I'm here for.
You saw that, because I did.
Put it in, let's go, right there. Watch your heads. Watch your heads, back up. Time in, let's go.
Well, as we've said, with Godfrey fighting so much out of that left-handed stance, that's inevitable, almost. Gets caught with a right hand. Backs him off, and once again, here we see Coyote trying to measure him.
Stop! Step back, step back. Let's box. Stop! Stop! Step back. Let's go. Box.
Godfrey's hanging in there, Kurt, but I don't know if he has the oomph left to do any damage. He's been a little worn down.
And this is where Coyote has gotten so many opponents in trouble. Just wears them down physically. And then it's oftentimes a body shot or the one blow that finishes them off after the accumulation of punches.
Let's go, Jimmy.
Don't forget, it's 10 months off for Godfrey as well.
It's amazing. This is his first fight since last August. This is the 4th fight for Coyote since last August.
Exactly. That puts it well.
Tells you how active he is in his young career.
I build the arms. Let's go.
Here he's got Godfrey in trouble on the ropes once again.
I tell you, Kurt, if Latif reached back anymore when he's punching, he's going to hit us. I mean, it's really, those are such telegraphed shots, but Godfrey's offering nothing in return. And I said it in the beginning of the fight, I'm going to repeat it, nothing's happened.
Oh, Godfrey kissing Coyote, taunting him.
You talk again, it's a point. You be clean, you understand me? You understand me?
Did he kiss him?
Let's go.
I saw him talking. Did he actually kiss him?
Well, he reached out.
I hear from the truck, he spit at him.
He spit at him is what we hear from the truck.
Wow. Now that's classic. You don't do that when you're winning, I'll tell you that. Shouldn't do it at all. But.
No.
Yeah, I saw him pucker his lips and lean forward and was blocked out by Coyote. I thought he blew him a kiss. Instead, he's trying to blow him a loogie.
Again, just not enough from Godfrey this round.
And obviously beginning to get frustrated.
Time.
Not exactly what you would expect out of a guy with the experience of Godfrey.
Do what you gotta do. You gotta let big punches. Every time you get close, you're falling in, you're losing your range. You're flat-footed and you're leaning out. Give yourself room.
Drink some more. You got two more rounds. I want you to
give yourself room. You got to land a big shot with this guy.
Here's another look.
Listen up, coach.
Let's see if we can see it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we have a good truck, huh? Producer Rich going right on that.
Well, some hot combinations, baby.
You gotta land.
That's gross. That's gross and classless.
Now, why not take a point away from
him? Referee might not have seen it. I'm with you, though.
You're never gonna land anything big. Get your feet right, land a big shot, finish with the fucking hook, step off.
I guess he could say it was accidental spitting.
Well, when he first opened his mouth, I thought he was trying to talk. You saw a little bit of a drool, which is not unusual after 8 rounds, but then you saw the spit actually come out of his mouth. That's not something you see too often, and I hope I don't see it again.
Well, it's interesting that the referee, Dan Stell, did warn him afterwards, so obviously he saw something. And now Coyote, as we get to the 9th round, trying to make him pay.
Godfrey from the Roberto Alomar School. Oh, left hook to the body.
And it drops Godfrey for the 3rd time tonight.
5, 6.
He's saying his foot was stepped on.
8. Come here. Box.
Godfrey didn't like the knockdown. He said that his foot was stepped on by Coyote. Our truck says that they saw it and that it was. But it's called a knockdown. 3rd one tonight.
A moot point, really, with Coyote this far ahead.
Right.
We've got a lot of knockdowns tonight.
Really have.
The 1st and 3rd fights.
4 in the 1st fight, including a knockout. 3 in this fight thus far.
Stop, step back.
And there's still almost 2 minutes to go here in round 9.
Stop, step back.
While we have a minute, I just want to wish sympathies on behalf of everybody in Showbox to the family of Genaro Hernandez, great 130-pound champ, died of cancer this week. He was a classy fighter and an incredibly classy guy.
Coyote had Godfrey in trouble for a little bit, but now you see Godfrey taunting once again.
This is getting X-rated.
Answering back, exactly.
What's going on here? These guys are supposed to be fighters. Well, Godfrey, it's from frustration, clearly.
I'll tell you what, a guy with Godfrey's experience, and there have been the places he's been in championship bouts, it's a little disappointing to see this out of him today. Not necessarily the performance as a fighter.
Yeah.
It's the act that he's had these last couple of rounds.
I'm with you, because he's been, you know, he's hanging in. He's been tough. He's taken punches. But I think maybe he feels not only the fight slipping away, but his days as a contender slipping away.
Coyote just keeps the pressure on.
Coyote listening to Freddie Roach, going to the body with that right hand to the stomach. Very effective punch, much harder to block than a shot to the head where you can slip.
Bring him up.
Left to the body, right to the head. We've seen that so many times in this fight, delivered by Coyote. And effectively. Those are just love taps there from Godfrey.
Yeah, Coyote goes to the ropes and he gets love taps. Godfrey goes to the ropes, he gets power shots. All right, I thought this was a left hook to the body, but apparently that left foot, yep. There was a punch, but clearly Godfrey went down because the foot, left foot of Coyote was on the right foot of Godfrey.
You want to be tired going home tomorrow thinking about it? You gotta walk him down and
you gotta knock him out.
You gotta go forward and throw some big shots.
I can't win this fight.
All right, you do not let him back you up. All right, the key is your jab. You be all right. You back him up with your jab. All right, and put the right hand to the body and left hook to the head. You hear me?
Keep it all here.
You gotta land something big, man. Find it. Pull his gloves down. Land something fucking big. Take a shot.
Don't let him back you up. Just take the fight to him. Okay? It's your fight.
After 14 consecutive knockouts, Latif Coyote now in the 10th round for his 2nd straight fight. But this has been a much more impressive performance than his last one. If this one goes the distance, there won't be any doubt as to who wins it. Coyote comes out following Freddie Roach's advice, taking it to Godfrey and backing Godfrey up.
Coyote full of energy here.
Yeah. And looking for the knockout. Godfrey trying to dodge those punches.
No, watch her feet.
And smiling on the break.
Godfrey's really good at slipping shots along the ropes. Problem with that is it doesn't win you fights.
And the problem is he hasn't been able to stay off the ropes. Coyote's done much of his busy work all night. Every time he gets Godfrey up against the ropes, that's when he puts the pressure on.
And if Lateef does get a title shot in a couple more fights, he won't see an opponent who fights this way. Steve Cunningham, a great boxer and mover. Marco Hook never stops punching and coming.
Stop, step back, step back.
Much tougher assignments. Lateef's gonna have to raise his game if he wants to win a world title. That cruiserweight division's loaded.
Would you still have a title fight in a couple of fights, or do you think he needs a few more tune-ups?
No, I don't think he needs too many more tune-ups because there's a limited pool of opposition
stop.
To fight
Bring it
in
up.
America.
This was a costume. You understand me? Let's go.
These people were talking about maybe an eliminator in his next fight.
And you don't return it.
Troy Ross is calling out the winner of this fight. That'd be an interesting fight up in Canada.
Stop! Go back. Box.
But much like Chris Avalos, who was coming off a loss, Coyote getting back on track.
Yeah. Coming off a victory, but a controversial victory. And what he admitted was his worst performance as a professional. Tonight, fought a much tougher opponent, much more experienced opponent than he's ever fought, and has been in control from that first round knockdown. A couple of big punches delivered as we get down to the final minute.
Stop, Stevet.
It's a punctuation point for Coyote.
And he's looking for the exclamation part.
Stop, step back.
Trying to get the knockout to finish it off. You can see Godfrey just looking weary right now. Can he hang on for another 33 seconds?
And when Godfrey's on the ropes, among his other problems, totally squared up. You can't get any power when you're squared up.
And he gets caught with a right hand bouncing off the ropes.
Let's go, let go, let go, let's go. Watch your head, it's fine, let's go. Put that on, Matt.
Oh, it looks like he's going to make it through this fight. Through all 10 rounds, but on our scorecards at least, and I'd be shocked if the judges don't agree, all 10 rounds in favor of Coyote. We get three knockdowns along the way, and we'll get another victory.
Kurt, go figure boxing. Coyote fights Iannuzzi, who's without credentials, and barely gets by with a win. And then he fights Godfrey, who's a much better fighter, a big step up, and he dominates. So that's boxing.
Russ.
Well, he got three knockdowns in this fight. And even if he hadn't gotten the knockdowns, this was a dominating one-sided performance by Lateef Coyote. But let's take a look back at exactly what happened beginning in the opening round. Final 10 seconds of what had been a fairly even first round until this.
Yeah, it was just a lapse of concentration by Godfrey because it was a straight right hand. But you can see how much more effective you could be when you throw straight shots, Lateef. Then in round five, referee Stell does rule that a knockdown. Round nine, clearly, Lateef twice steps on Godfrey's foot. But the judges have to score what the referee indicates, and the referee ruled the knockdown, so that's a 10-8 round, whether you believe it's a knockdown, legitimate knockdown, or not. So not much drama, I don't think, with the scores here, Kurt.
If it's anything other than what? Every round in favor of Coyote plus three 10-8 rounds, I think we'll be stunned.
Exactly.
But let's make it official by sending it up to our ring announcer, Mark Lichtenfeld, who has the judges' scorecards.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Chumash Casino Resort in Santa Ynez, California, after 10 hard-hitting rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. Kermit Bayless scores the bout 98-90. Sergio Caí sees it 97-90. And Marshall Walker scores it 98-89 for your winner by unanimous decision. And now the NABA and still NABF Cruiserweight Champion Latif Power Coyote.
And so a couple of judges give a couple of rounds to Matt Godfrey. Doesn't matter. One-sided decision, nonetheless, a unanimous decision, and Latif Coyote keeps on marching, 17 fights, 17 victories, as he continues his run through the cruiserweight division on his way towards an eventual title fight someday, and he hopes someday soon.